service from Family Worship Center. This service is also being broadcast live on Sun Life Radio, online worldwide at sunlifetv.com, and on the free SBN app. We'll have praise and worship from the Family Worship Center singers and musicians, a time for prayer, plus the anointed preaching from God's Word. Now, let's go live to the Family Worship Center sanctuary as the service begins.
go ahead and bring our boxes as we receive our tithe and offering. Tell you what, go ahead and just sit down just for a moment, because I just want to say something, and I won't take much time, but I think it's important. As you know, the Share-a-thon is coming up the 15th, the 16th, the 19th, the 20th. We need all of our volunteers. This morning, I awakened about 4:30, and I was studying the first chapter of the book of Matthew. And when I got to the verse that said, the scripture said, "And you shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins." And when I read that, the Spirit of the Lord just flooded my heart and flooded my soul. When I came in for service this morning, there was a spirit in this house this morning. I mean, the Spirit of the Lord. And it was a spirit of freedom. It was a spirit of life. It was a spirit of joy. And this is what I want to tell you. God has raised up in different parts of the world ministries to touch their region. But God has raised up this church, this ministry, and this television network to touch the world. Now, do you understand that? And I'm going to say something else that I'm sure we always have detractors. You know, I don't understand people. If I don't like somebody on television, I don't watch them. But we got some people that don't like us that watch us. You know what that tells us? They're under conviction, and they're still watching, and they're mad. But sooner or later, they're going to be glad because they're going to get right, okay? But I know some may not agree with what I'm about to say. But I know that I am 100% right. This is the only ministry today that God has divinely called to reach the world. I don't back up from saying that. God has raised up others for their local areas and their communities. But we have a worldwide commission. And there are people today around the world that Jesus is just a name. But through Sun Life Broadcasting Network, they're going to find out that in that name there's healing, there's salvation, there's deliverance. There's peace. There's joy. As this network, which Dad didn't even mention, there's several things in the hopper right now. Doors that are opening that we cannot say until all the I's are dotted, the T's are crossed, and everything's taken care of. But I'm saying all that to say this. Folks, please, and you watching, don't take this work for granted. Souls what we do or don't do as it regards the Share-a-thon, it all plays out to whether somebody hears or someone doesn't hear. And so I'm going to ask you, as I said this morning, we need your faith, we need your prayers. You watching, we need your faith, we need your prayers, and we need your money. As C.M. Ward said so long ago, the gospel can only go as far as the dollar bill can take it. The message is free, but transporting that message, it costs something. And so, please, please, I know you that are volunteers, it's very easy to get in a rut. Well, it's the time of Share-a-thon, we're going to go up there, but that's the devil. This is more important than you'll ever realize. And I'm going to ask you, I'm asking you as one of your pastors to begin to seek the Lord that hearts would be opened up in this nation. Because listen, the bottom line is the United States of America has to carry 90% of the weight as it regards the finances. Because we're the nation that God has blessed. And there's many voices in the world today that purport to be the voice of the Lord. Most of them is just noise, but there is still a voice, and his voice makes a difference. So please, please, don't get complacent. Don't get in a rut. This is just another month, another sheriff. I know it's about souls. Amen? Amen? Amen. And they need to hear that name Jesus, which means Savior. Hallelujah. Now you can stand back up. As we get ready to march around and drop in our tithes and offering, let me also just say that in the lobby, that Brother Mills has a product table, and you need to go back after the service if you haven't already and avail yourself of his CDs and his other items. We will be taking an offering for Brother Walt at the end of the service. If you only have enough to give in one offering, hold it. Don't give it in this offering. Hold it for the offering that we receive for him. Father, we come before you in the name of your son, Jesus. We thank you for your goodness, your kindness, your graciousness. Lord, we're ever mindful of the responsibility that you have placed in our hands. We must never take that responsibility lightly. We live in a big world with a lot of hurting and a lot of pain and a lot of darkness, but you are the light that can penetrate that darkness. I'm asking you to revive our people, to give them a joy and an urgency of knowing that what they're doing will translate into souls. Bless them as they give. And we give you all the praise and all the glory. And everybody said, amen and amen. March around and drop in your gifts.
I've got one more ribbon to throw.
Amen. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. We are always delighted to have Brother and Sister Mills come and minister in word and song. And this is just me speaking, but I know I'm right. That without a doubt, Walt Mills is one of the greatest singers in America today. And we love it when he comes. Brother Walt, we're turning it over to you. You think you got it? You sure you got it? I know you got it.
Let's do it. Every morning down here to roll.
just look for me around God's throne. We've had a wonderful day today. It's always our pleasure and our fun to come down and minister to you, and you've been so kind with your compliments to, you know, how you've been blessed and helped and those things, and that makes us feel good to know that the Lord's using you to touch somebody else's life. And those that didn't particularly care for it, you were kind enough to just keep your mouth shut. Oh, my, my. This is a song that I wrote here some time back, and I'd like to sing it tonight. Y'all going to help me? These are dandies back here. They sure are. All right, let's do it. Shed blood. anxious to get into the message tonight, but I'd like to sing a song that I sung this morning. It's just been in my spirit. And I would like to sing it for my son. He's watching tonight. The enemy tried to kill him here a few weeks ago, and I don't mean that, you know, just to say something. He literally was dying. And he's home tonight. He hadn't been able to get out of his home for weeks now. Oh. And I would ask you to pray for him, that God will bring him completely to his health. And I know we got praying people that go to this church. And so, if you will, his name is Paul. That's easy to remember. His name is Paul, and call his name out to God in prayer, and that healing that he is needing will come to pass very soon. Always a delight for us to be here, and we always are happy when Francis will call or we'll talk with Jimmy or whatever, and they'll say, we want you to come such and such, and we're always happy when they invite us down. And you've got to realize that you have something very special in the leadership that God has sent to you. That's the truth. And I love you, and there's nothing you can do about that. Absolutely nothing. But I want to share a message with you in just a moment, but go ahead and let's sing A Very Special Grace. When Satan If so, maybe God help me to write one. But if they are, this has to be number one on the heavenly hit parade. Amazing Grace, will you stand?
How sad.
Feels like you're trying to quit and you don't know where to stop. When we've
Thank you.
Jesus.
Glory, glory, glory.
It'll come to me in a minute.
Hallelujah.
I want you to just keep standing. God is changing the order of the service.
Jesus, Jesus.
And
the Spirit. Glory.
And you know what? That's a wonderful thing to know.
Yes, it is.
It just puts you every way God wants to take it.
Amen.
I go that way.
Yes.
And you've got a shepherd and a and these folks, and you want it to go that way.
Yes, yes, yes.
If you if you don't want it to go that way, you won't be comfortable here. But God is changing the order of service. I came prepared to take a text and go from there.
Praise God for Jesus.
Yes. We're standing
at home. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God.
Listen, praise God. This another time, but I want you tonight that you're concerned and you have a burden for those in your family or someone dear to you that is unsaved. If they died tonight in their present condition, they would wake up in a devil's hell. But I want you tonight that you are concerned, and I want to share a little bit with you after you come, but I want you to step out and come forward and feel this, because we're going to pray for them. Just come and stand here, and we're going to sing this again in a moment. Oh, this is good. Praise God. I want you to listen to me, please. Real softly. And I want you to listen to me. My dad, I was raised rough. But I never once doubted my father's love. Some of you can't say that, perhaps. And my dad was not a saved man. And do not fool with one of his family, because he would hurt you bad and might even take you out, because you just didn't fool with him in some malicious way. But I prayed for my dad for 19 years. For 19 years. Some of you can relate to that kind of thing. But let me tell you something. Don't you dare give up on it. Don't you dare give up on it. My dad, we had Christmas together, the family. Didn't matter where we were. We always made it a point to be home Christmas, and it's still that way. But we didn't know that would be the last Christmas that we'd get to be together. My dad had his own band at one time, and he played piano. I have home footage of me sitting beside him playing the piano. He was so sick. And me sitting beside him playing my guitar and him playing the piano, and we were singing. But about 3 o'clock that night, they had to rush him to the hospital. He was hemorrhaging. And he died with cirrhosis of the liver. When I say hemorrhaging, he was very ill. And I went to the hospital to see him, and the doctor there said, "Your father's liver is gone. It doesn't function." And he said that all the poison in his body will be released. And he said, when he sees you, and he always knew me when I walked in, but he said, when he sees you, he may know you, may not. And he said, even if he knows you, he perhaps will get off just talking about whatever. And that went on for day after day. And I was sitting there, I loved my father. And some occasionally would come and be in one of my services, but he'd walk out. And it grieved you. But we prayed for 19 years. I'd pray for him singly, but then in a meeting like we're having here tonight, call people forward and say, "We're going to pray for your loved ones." And then I'd say, "After we have prayed for your loved ones, I'm going to ask you to pray for my dad, that he'll come to Christ." I was sitting there in the hospital and just looking at him. His eyes were closed, and I was just looking at him. And he became aware that someone was in the room with him. And he opened his eyes and he said, "What are you doing, boy?" And I said, "Oh, I was just thinking." That has a way of doing you that way. I was just thinking. He said, "Well, don't do it. It'll worry you." But the night before he passed away, we were there, my wife and I, and the one that used to pastor the church where our son pastors, he and his wife were there, and I came in, and again, here's the head of my father's bed, and I've walked around, and here's the head of his bed, and the pastor and his wife, they were standing over here, and he became aware that someone was in the room, and again, he asked, "Well, why are you doing here?" And I said, "We've come to pray for you, Dad." And he thanked me for that. And I reached over and put my hand on his head. And I said, "Jesus, touch him. Touch him." And he became awake and as rational as I'm talking to you right now. And probably for 15 or 20 minutes, we talked. But in the conversation, he was looking at the pastor and his wife, but he was talking to me. He said, "That boy over there thought he had a lost dad, but he don't." Jesus was so gracious to let me hear that.
and I wanted to hear that. I've never worried about him 3 seconds. I'll see him again. But the point I'm wanting to make tonight is, I don't know how long you may have prayed for some loved one or someone dear to you in some way, but don't you give up. Don't you give up. And we're going to pray for them. And as we pray, and as you intercede in your private time, or as this is, believe me, God will send conviction. Really, bottom line, church people were just a bunch of sissies to me. I didn't want nothing to do with them. But I learned the hard way when God just ready to put his hand on you, buddy, he knows how, and make your life totally miserable until you get it straightened out. But he's in heaven tonight, and I'll get to see him again. I go by his grave sometime just to see it. But I'm aware too that once we're there, Donnie, we'll never have to say goodbye again. Yeah, never have to say goodbye again. I want us to sing, y'all are doing such a wonderful job. I want us to sing one more time, and then we're going to pray. We're standing on holy ground, and we are, Jesus is here.
Praise God.
We slip up your hand that are unsaved. We're going to pray.
Praise God.
Donnie, would you agree with in faith with me tonight, please? And
Jesus
will send conviction. It's left up to them what they're going to do with it. But like I said, God knows how to make your life so miserable. Until I went to the altar to get saved, I can tell you one thing that man said. He could have said Mary had a little lamb whose fleece was white as snow. Come to the altar. I'd have gone. I'd have gone. I went there to find Jesus. I'm broken tonight, but it's real. It's real.
Come on.
Lord, you know who's on their hearts here tonight, the unsaved, those who have slipped away from God and are in a backslidden condition. Send conviction to them. Those that perhaps have never known you, send conviction to them. And Lord Jesus, you know how to work. You know how to work the incidents around them to bring them to the foot of the cross. Jesus, I am so thankful for what you accomplished for us on Calvary and by your sacrifice. And Lord Jesus, I ask you to save their unsaved loved ones. I ask you to save them. Bring them, bring them, bring them to Jesus. To Jesus. To Jesus. But that's it. Just let the Holy Ghost speak through you. Yes. Would you sing that again? We're standing on holy ground. We're standing on holy ground. Just one more prayer, please. I'm going to ask Donnie to come.
No, ma'am.
Just a moment. I have a grandson.
No.
The mama keeps saying it's too early.
Jesus. And we've prayed for your loved ones and expect something to take place. I want you, if you will, there's no magic in this. It's just saying we're in agreement. But I want you to stretch your hand this way. And I want you to pray for my grandson that God will save him and that he soon will bring it to pass. Father, I thank you tonight, and you know who's on my heart. He's been a heartache. And God, you only know what's going on in his life right now. But I ask you to save him. I ask you to draw him. Draw him to Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Praise the name of Jesus. I'll tell you, I just ain't no hurry. Just wonderful. I won't turn it to you, but it's just wonderful. I'm going to ask you this one more time.
Jesus.
Let's sing We're Standing on Holy Ground. I'm going to ask Brother Donnie to come and thank you for being here tonight. You're a blessing. You're a blessing to us.
Oh,
has his order, and God has his order. We prepare, we study, we come to preach, but then the true preacher, the true teacher, takes over. And it becomes the best sermon you never preach.
Amen.
The best sermon you never preach, because the Holy Spirit knows exactly what is needed. Did you enjoy what we received tonight? I'm so glad that Dad taught me as a little boy when it comes to finances to give to God. I can still remember the first time I ever had a $5 bill in my hand. And he explained to me that 10% of that $5 bill was not mine. It was God's. Secondly, I'm glad that he taught me. He said there are going to be times that you will sit under someone else's ministry. You may be in a car, turn on a Christian radio station, whatever the case, a person you may not know, but they'll preach something that'll be just for you. It will speak to your heart. It will minister to you. And even though you don't know them, you owe them an offering for what you have received. And all the years that I've traveled, there have been times in a hotel room or whatever, turning on a Christian, somebody I didn't know, some local guy, but he blessed me. And I would look up the address in the phone book and get the hotel envelope and just put a little note, say I was passing through town and heard the program and you made this statement or you brought this out and it blessed me, and here is a little gift for you to continue on with the work that the Lord has given you. Well, we didn't receive a little word tonight. We received a great word tonight. And evangelist, you got to understand something. When you're an evangelist, this is how you make your living. You have to depend on other people having enough love of God to bless your ministry when you minister to them. And if they don't obey, you don't eat. You can't pay your bills. There's no one to underwrite you. An evangelist depends upon the generosity of those that the Lord allows him to minister to. Now, we have received something great tonight, so we in turn want to give something great. So I'm going to ask you to be as generous as possible. If you make out a check,
we hope you were blessed and enjoyed this live service from Family Worship Center. Family Worship Center, located in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, at Jimmy Swagger Ministries, holds three services weekly, Sunday morning at 10 a.m., Sunday evening at 6 p.m., and Wednesday at 7 p.m., all Central Time. All services are broadcast live on the Sun Life Broadcasting Network, including Sun Life Radio, online worldwide at sunlifetv.com, and on the free SBN Now app. To join the Family Worship Center Media Church, call 1-800-288-8350 or join at jsm.org. Live services are produced by the Sun Life Broadcasting Network.